Students, welcome. Let's begin with the computer programming C++. C++ is a very basic language and it is widely used everywhere today. Many more programs, many more languages have also come into existence like Java, Python, but C++ has its own importance. It is the basis of all the languages that you will study. So it is very necessary for you all to study the C++ language and to understand the concepts and the basics of C++. So let's begin with C++. So C++ is a general purpose object oriented program. It is also referred to as the OOP language, that is object oriented program language, and it is developed by the Bijan Strauss-Trupp at his lab that was established at the AT&T Bell Labs, and that was in the year 1980s. He found that the C language was lacking. Initially, the language that was developed was the C language. So C language had lacked its efficiency in the areas of simulation and many other fields. So there was a requirement for the development of a higher level language than the C language. That was how the C++ came into existence. So what is the advantage of the C++ language? That the C++ language overcame the problems regarding the simulation that was faced in the C language. So since the C language lacked the simulation problems, so it was decided to extend this C language by adding certain features in this C particular language, and the Bijan Strauss-Trupp had added his favorite language Simula 67 formulas or certain aesthetics of these Simula 67 into the C language, and this is how the C++ came into the existence. So originally C++ was called by C with classes. So there were classification in the C language. So that is why it was called as the C with classes. Then the name C++ was coined by Rick Massetti. So Rick Massetti coined the name C++ to the higher version of the C. And what is the plus-plus telling about? Plus-plus is the C increment operator. When you will learn about the C++ language, when you will have to add a certain one number, then the operator is plus plus. When you write plus plus, this means that you are giving an increment of one to the particular step. So plus plus is the C increment operator. So C++ is considered as the intermediate level language, and it encapsulates both the high and the low level language features. So it is an intermediate, it is a bridge between the high level language and the low level language. So you would be studying about the C++ features. So the C++ features will be including many operators such as the arithmetic calculation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, remainder, modulus. You would be seeing all the operations regarding the arithmetic calculations can be done in this C language. You can do comparison also, you can do bit manipulations also, and logical operations can also be performed in this C language. So logical operation involves the binary operation, that is the addition, that is the AND gate, OR gates, NOT gates, NOT gates. So all the gates or the binary operations can be done using the C++ language. It also includes the polymorphism, virtual, friendly function. The C language is very friendly. It can include templates, it can include namespaces, pointers, abstractions, encapsulations, modularity, inheritance. So various terms will be dealt in the next sections when we will move further. So now let's see how to load the C language in your systems. So let us see the steps of the loading of the C level language. So these are the steps to how to download this Dev C++ in your systems. So first, In the step one, I have shown here that go to the sourceforge.net/projects/OrwellDaveCPP. PP stands for C++. There are many other sites also where you can download the C++. There are free softwares available for the download of the C++ language. So this is one of the software. So download it, go to the site sourceforge.net/projects.orwelldavecpp/. Then you would get certain type of window in your system. Then go on the, click the download button. You can see here, there is a download button here. So click this download button. The downloading will then start. Then it will redirect you to the thank you page. Then what you will get, you will be getting that thank you for downloading the Dave C++ like this. Then you go to the download section where the downloading has taken place in the browser of your computer. And then once the download is complete, you will get certain type of pop-up or the window in your laptop or the computer. When the download is complete, then the open the installer. There is a icon coming open. So open the installer by clicking on it. Then choose the desired language for the installer. So here you can see a tab or a window like this. And when you will click this arrow mark, there would be, it would be asking for the various languages you want to opt for. So click on the English language that is most convenient now. So you can also choose any of the regional languages also. So click on the English language, then click on the next button, read. It will show a license agreement window will be opened. Then click on the agree button that you are agreeing to this policy of the software. Then choose the required components and then click next. When you choose the required components, you have to tick all that. Then you choose the installation location where you want to install this software in your laptop or computer. So give it a path. Give it, you want to save it on the desktop, you want to save in the C drive, D drive, or you want to save into some folders in of your account. So choose your installation path like this. Here is the destination folder is showing that it is saving this software in the C/program files/devs.cpp. So you can choose any of the desired part of your choice and then click on the next button. So when it will, you will choose the desired place where it has to be stored, then the installing will be start. Then it would be extracting all the files of the Dave CPP and then click on the next button and the installation will be complete. You will get a message that the installation has taken place, complete setup has taken place, and you have successfully installed it. So this is the Dave C++ file that you will see. So in the beginning, you can see that the words are coming, file, edit, search, view. These are similar to what you see in your Word files or Excel files. So now click on the file button and open the new file. So in the new source file, you will see such type of window and here you will type it. So number one is showing that the this is the first row in which you will start coding your, write coding the language. So now let's see what is happening. So now let's begin with the first program of our C language. So the first program is generally a welcome program or a hello program. So we shall write in the coding hello world and we shall see that when we execute our program, is hello world coming out or not coming out. So I have written here that the first C program is a hello world program. Why do we choose the Hello World program? Because this Hello World or the welcome program is a standard check to see whether everything is working fine in our C language. So, and this Hello World program is a basic or very intuitive program in which very less amount of coding is involved. So less code is there in the program to start and the coding is so intuitive, so basic that even the beginners like you all or anyone who is the beginner in the coding language or the coding world will find it very interesting and be attracted to the coding language. So it gets very well versed with the program language. And this Hello World program is so easy that one understands the what is the basics of the coding language and what steps he has to write. So this Hello World program is enough to learn the basic syntax and the semantics of the language. So now let's go coding. So you can see here I have written the coding language. So the coding starts here. The very first line that you have to write in the coding is that hash, this is the hash, include, then less than or greater than quotes we have to write IOStream. Somewhere in some software we use IOStream or we use IOStream.h. .h is the extension. So it is dependent upon the software which you have downloaded. Some works with without the extension .h and some works without it. And some works with it. So the first statement that you have to type in your coding language is hash include IOStream. Then you have to write using namespace standard, and then you have to insert the semicolon. Then you write int. Int stands for integer, then main, then bracket. You have to open the bracket and close the bracket. Then there is a curly bracket. This curly bracket you can see. So you have to start the curly brackets. Then we wanted to print our IOS Hello World. So we have given cout. Cout means output statement that will type it in the executing file. So cout, and there is a less than quotes. And then we have written in the quotations Hello World. And then a semicolon, then return zero. And then the curly brackets are closed. So each term I shall be explaining you ki what does each term represents. So when you will execute the program will print Hello World in the output. So now let's see how this coding works. Everybody could see. So I have written down, I have copied this. So you have to write hash include in the less than greater than quotes. You have written IOStream, then using namespace standard, then semicolon, then int main, bracket open, bracket close, then curly brackets is starting. We have to execute our file and write out the Hello World. So we have written Hello World. You can write welcome, whatever you want to type. So you can give the quotation, inside the quotations, you write your message. Then semicolon means that the line is complete. Your statement is complete. The statement is terminating at this point. Then return zero, then again semicolon, and the curly bracket is closed. Now we want to execute the file. So you can see at the top, there is an execute button. Either you go there and press the F11 function or compile and run. Or you can see here blocks also. In this one block is also showing compile and run. So this is a shortcut key or shortcut key. So you can press this also to directly execute. So when you execute this, a window will pop up and you can see at the top that the Hello World is being printed. So this means that our program has been executed and we are now at the beginning level that we have started using the coding language and we have come to know about the coding. So now let's move ahead. So now you have understood the basic of the language. So let's see what is the basic structure of C++ language, how the language is coded. So the first step in the language is to in first line is hash include in the less than greater than we write the IOStream, and I have already told that some software uses the extension .h and somewhere it works without .h. So you have to test it whether it is working with .h or without .h. Then you write some of the header files. Then there is a main. The main is also in integer or it is a float function. So we write here the main, and the brackets are opened and closed. In this, how many variables you have to take in, that is an open-ended source. So we don't mention any value here. Somewhere in the program, we mention the values also. So that will be discussed in the later modules. So then the curly bracket is open and the closed, and here we write the our body. So whatever programming we have to write, we write in the curly bracket quotations. So this is the main structure of the C++ program. So I have here written in the red markers, the demo program, like the welcome program or the hello world. So it includes that hash include iostream.h, then int main, then the curly brackets are opened and closed, and within it we are writing the body, that is the C out we want to print. Now welcome to C++. So whatever you want to get printed, it must be within quotations. If you are not putting these quotes, then nothing will be printed, it will not be executed. Then return zero, then the curly bracket is closed. So again, when you will write this program in your dev CPP and you will execute the file, what you will get? You will get the result as welcome to C++. If you have written hello world, it will write as hello world. So we can say this is the basic structure of the C++ language. Now let us see how our program works. So you can see here our coding was basically divided into 6 parts. First step was the writing of the first line, first statement, that is hash include iostream dot h. Then the second important component to write here is the using namespace standard. So here I have written that dash dash after include iostream. So it means that there are some header files which have to be included. So using namespace standard is also a header file. Then what is most important is the semicolons. Why semicolons are important? Because it tells us about the termination of our particular statement, that after the semicolon is written, this means that our statement, our line has been completed. We don't want to interpret anything after this line, means this is acting as a full stop of a line. So semicolon is acting as a full stop in the coding world, in the C++ coding world. Then the fourth component is the int main and the brackets. Then the curly brackets are used in which we write the body of the program. Then second last is the C out. C out is the output statement. You must have remembered the input and output statement. So C out is the output statement, but what you want to print your result as. So C out. And here we have printed the welcome to C++ or hello world. And then you have to always remember to put a semicolon, because if you are not putting semicolon, it will not take that this line is complete and the next statement will be considered in the previous statement only. Then return zero. Return zero is not mandatory. It is a custom to write return zero. So we write generally return zero. And then a semicolon. So in this way, the coding is divided into 6 major parts. First, include iostream.h and the hashtag is necessary. Then using namespace standard, then putting semicolons after every statement, then int main, then the output statement, then return zero. So this is how our coding will work, and these are to be remembered. So now I will explain in detail whatever is the of the parts that you have studied here. So we have seen that our program was divided into 6 main parts. So the first part is the first line, that is hash include iostream.h. So here in this is the header file. So it is a standard C++ input output library file. So there are many library files in the C++ language. So this is one of the input output library file. This is a standard input output library file. So it includes file in the program, and this ensures that we will be able to use the operations, iostream operations, in anywhere in the program if we have used the iostream. Means we, whatever functions are inbuilt in the library of the C++ that can be used in the program, it will automatically include it. So it includes the file into the program, and it ensures that now we are able to use the operation, the iostream operations, anywhere in the program. So next is the second statement, that is the using namespace standard. So this statement is very intuitive, very basic, and whatever is written here, it is specifying, it is conveying the message in itself. Using namespace standard means we are using the namespace in the standard format. So it is intuitive in itself, means it is self-understanding. We are using the namespace standard in our file. We use it to make it ensure to reference operations included in that namespace. So whatever libraries are there in the dev CPP, so we can use all the files in our program. So next is the namespace. What do you mean by namespace? So namespace is the region in the dev CPP. C++ library storage factor that our coding is residing in that namespace. So it limits or expands the scope of our code to one or more files. So it is not that we are supposed to be keeping our coding to just one program. We can expand it to many sub programs also. So this namespace will limit or expand our scope of the code to one or more files. And then use of namespace is to avoid the confusion of which variable we are referring to. Then the word comes std. So what do you mean by std? Std means standard. So it is a standard namespace in the C++ program. So then the third part was the semicolon. As I have already mentioned, that it is a terminal. It means it is acting as a full stop in the ordinary language that we write in our text. So it is a terminal. It terminates the statement. That line has now terminated. It has stopped there. So when you read the next line has no meaning with the above written line. So semicolon means the terminal. Then we have the int main. So what do you mean by int main? Int main is the main function. So this means that the main function, main program that we are writing is now getting started. So it is the main function of the program, and whatever we write inside these curly brackets, that is the body of our program. So whatever statements you are writing inside the curly brackets is the body, and these statements have to be executed first before any other statement gets executed. So the statements that are written inside the curly brackets are executed first when we execute our C++ program. Then we have the return zero. Return zero means it is a return statement. We have to return to the original from where we started if we have a loop, something like that in our program. So it is a return statement, and it is not mandatory to return every time. So sometimes when you will see the codings, somewhere return zero will be omitted. So it is not return zero is mandatory compulsion to write, but it is a custom to write return zero. So that's why we write it. So it is not mandatory to return anything from the main function, but it is a convention, it is a custom to write return zero. And sometimes the program also continues without writing return zero also. The last one that we have missed, that is the cout. Cout means that it is an output stream. It is an output statement. So for the statement, we use the word stream. So what does this mean? So the cout is an object of the standard output stream. Whatever is written in the quotations will be printed on the output stream. So it prints the data at the stream after these less than signs. Two less than signs are written. If you miss these two less than signs, then the function will not work. There will be an error in the execution. So you don't forget to insert these less than sign. So where we have when we will execute it, what will be written? It will be written welcome to C++ into a stream. So what is a stream? Stream is basically a set of objects, usually bytes. So whatever is being written, it is not a statement. It is a bytes word. So stream is basically a set of objects called bytes. And the less than two less than signs are the insertion operation used to write the formatted data into the stream or into the statement, whatever you want to understand it. So the less than sign is the insertion operation, and these less than signs are used in the input statement as well as in the output statement. So this is how the basic structure of the C++ program is working, and we don't have to forget any of these lines to be included in our program. If any of the line is forgot by us, then the program will show an error in the execution.